As it turns out, the internet's design is actually fundamentally insecure. Many explicit design choices have caused the internet to be vulnerable to different types of attacks. The internet was designed for simplicity, and as a result, security was not a primary consideration when the internet was originally designed. Another aspect of the internet's design is that it's on by default. In other words, when a host is connected to the internet, it is by default reachable by any other host that has a public IP address. This means that if one has an insecure host, that host is effectively wide open to attack by other hosts on the internet. Now, this wasn't a primary design consideration when the internet consisted of a small number of trusted networks. But as the internet has continued to grow, this on-by-default design, or the notion that any host should always be reachable by any other host, has come under fire. Part of the reason that the on-by-default model does not work that well is that hosts are insecure. This makes it possible for a remote attacker to compromise a machine that's connected to the internet and commandeer it for the purposes of attack. In many cases, an attack might actually just look like normal traffic. For example, in the case of an attack on a victim web server, every individual request to that web server might look normal, but the collection of requests together, mounted as part of a distributed denial of service attack, might add up to a volume of traffic that the server is unable to handle. Finally, the internet's federated design obstructs cooperation for diagnosis or mitigation. In other words, because the internet is run by tens of thousands of independently operated networks, it can be very difficult to coordinate the defense against an attack because each of these networks is run by different network operators, sometimes in completely different countries.